Morning students, Sai Ram. In our previous class of lesson number 7, we have learnt about the technological progress that is done by India and also about the telex services, the telecommunication centers, satellite communication centers, which help further for the economic progress and also technological development of the country, because of which we could see that the means of production as well as marketing and also exchange of ideas have become more quicker and by faster mode. So let's proceed today with the next part of our history lesson number 7, science and technology, that is part 5. So in this part today we'll be learning about the further developments. Like for example, as we have learnt about the telecommunication centers, so you all are very much aware about the pin codes, okay, which we write during our letters. In our when we write a letter, we write the pin code of an area, of whichever area, locality you are residing. So what actually is a pin code, we'll try to understand. From 15th August 1972, the Post and Telegraph Department started the 6-digit PIN code system in the country. So when was the PIN code system started? From 15th August 1972. That is the Post and Telegraph Department had started. That is, the postal index code was intended to bring efficiency in distributing the mail. So whatever may be the letters to be posted, with the help of the pin code, it would become more easier and more convenient to post. So what is the full form? That is the postal index code. Okay, then in this system, the country was divided into 9 regions. Yes, so for this pin code system, we could see that the country was divided into 9 regions. Now, what is the importance of the PIN code? So, as we all know, it is of 6 digits, right? So, the first digit of the PIN code, it indicates the region. The second digit, it indicates the sub-region. The third digit, it shows the main disbursement district. Okay? So, first digit, it tells you about the region. Second digit tells the sub-region, and the third digit, it shows the main disbursement district, and while the remaining 3 digits, they show the location of the local post office. So whichever area the letter has to be posted, so the next 3 digits, they show the location of that post office. For Maharashtra, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44 are the first 2 digits. Okay, so which are the digits for Maharashtra? 40, 41, 42, 43 and 44. In 1986, the speed post service was started to send postage rapidly. So what was started in 1986? The speed post service, right? So it would be more faster than the postman would drop the letter. So this speed post would become more faster. Then, International Subscriber Dialing Telephone Service, that is the ISD. Now, prior there were no mobiles, no internet connection. So at that time we had this ISD, wherein through the landline calls also you could connect to the international calls. Okay, so this International Subscriber Dialing Telephone Service, in 1972, Overseas Communication Service was established in Mumbai for the management of International Telecommunication Center Service. So in order to carry out the international affairs easily and more faster, this International Subscriber Dialing Telephone Service was started in 1972 for the management of International Telecommunication Service. In 1976, the International Subscriber Dialed Telephone Service was started to connect Mumbai and London directly on phone. So in order to connect the foreign countries with the regions, local areas, so this service was started. So in 1976, the service was started to connect Mumbai and London directly on phone. Alongside the telephone service, services like telex, teleprinter and radio images were started. Along with this, there were other services like the telex, teleprinter and radio images. In 1986, Videsh Sanchar Nigam, that is the VSNL, took a big leap in this field. So, in 1986, it was Videsh Sanchar Nigam that came into existence. As we had before that, MTNL, that is the Mahanagar Telephone Nigam, was public sector company for giving telephone service in big cities. So, MTNL would provide public services to the big city, telephone services to the big cities. Even this landline phones which were connected in every house, that were provided by the MTNL. And then in 1990s, Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited held the distinction of being the main internet service provider. So, VSNL was the main internet service provider. In India, the contribution of Sam Pitroda in this field is significant. So, who has greatly contributed in this field? Sam Pitroda. Now, then came the mobile phones. So, on 22nd August 1994, the mobile phone service was started in India. So, when was the mobile phone service started? It was started on 22nd August 1994. At this time, a mobile handset cost rupees 45,000 and calling was at rupees 17 per minute. So, what was the cost of the mobile phone at that time? Compare the cost now and when it was started in 1994. See, around it was 45,000 and per call it was 17 rupees per minute. Okay, so for 1 minute you would give 17 rupees. So just imagine now on for hours we speak on the phone and how much do we pay? So by 1990, many private companies came in this field. So we could see that many private companies had come across in this field and this service became more cheaper, right? Then Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, that is the BSNL, in 2000 the telecommunication department was restructured and the responsibility to make policy decisions was retained with the telecom department, and Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited was established to actually provide the services to consumers along with the telephone service, cellular phone, internet, broadband services were also made available. So we could see that it was Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited which has started the internet service, wherein then next we had the BSNL, that is the Bharat Sanchar Nigam, and it was established for what? To provide services to the consumers, like we would get SIM cards, right, of BSNLs, to provide services to the consumers along with the telephone service also, plus internet connections to the mobile phones. Thus cards were available, SIM cards were available for the cellular phones, and even the broadband system was available, like we have the Wi-Fi now. Then apart from this telecommunication centers, we could see that as it progressed in the further exchanging of ideas and also carrying out the foreign affairs more smoothly. Yes, then we had the ONGC, that is the Oil and Natural Gas Commission. In 1956, the Oil and Natural Gas Commission was established to search for the deposits of mineral oil and natural gas and to increase their production. So, for what was this ONGC established? In order to search for the deposits of mineral oil and natural gas and how it could increase the production. So, after Digboi in Assam, mineral oil deposits were found in Ankleshwar area in Gujarat. Mineral oil and natural gas deposits were found in the Gulf of Khambat in Gujarat. So, where was the deposits of mineral oil found? In Digboi in Assam, then Ankleshwar area in Gujarat, and natural gas deposits were found in the Gulf of Khambat in Gujarat. Okay, so Ankleshwar in Gujarat, we could see that there was mineral oil deposits. Then in 1974, the Oil and Natural Gas Commission started digging an oil well in Bombay High area with the help of Russian scientists by a drill ship called Sagar Samrat. So, what was started in 1974? The Oil and Natural Gas Commission, it started digging oil wells. Where? In Bombay High area. And who associated? The Russian scientists. By and how it was done? By drilling by a drill ship called Sagar Samrat. From 1975, mineral oil and natural gas began to be extracted from there. So from 1975, mineral oil and natural gas began to be extracted from there. Later, more than 8,500 oil wells and 33 natural gas wells dug eventually. So how many? 8,500 oil wells and 33 natural gas were dug. In this area began to contribute 38% of the total mineral oil production in the country. So how much of oil production was contributed? Around 38% of the total mineral oil. And it met around 14% of the country's demand for crude oil. Okay. Then. Now, apart from that, let's see how the transportation system was affected with this technology. So, railways and technology. The technology adopted by railways has a big role in the history of modern India. For example, just take Konkan Railway. Konkan Railway, it was started in 1998. And there are several records of technology to the credit of Konkan Railway. It stretches over the four states of Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka and Kerala. So how much distance does it covers? Around 760 kilometers. So where it has spread out? In Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka and Kerala. There are 12 tunnels on this track. How many tunnels are there? There are 12 tunnels on this track. The 6.5 kilometer tunnel at Karbude is the longest tunnel. Then we have, there are 179 big and 1819 small bridges on this track. Out of these, the 2065.8 meter long bridge on river Sharavati near Hanavar is the biggest bridge. Yes. Then you'll find the 64 kilometer tall bridge on river Panvel near Ratnagiri is India's tallest bridge. Now for avoiding accidents on the tracks that are prone to landslides, so the tracks which are prone to occur landslides there, and to avoid these accidents, there are sensors that are fitted to the railway engines. So in this we see what kind of precaution has been taken, children. In order to bring efficiency, accuracy and coordination in the reservation system in rail travel, computerized reservation system was started for the first time in Delhi in 1984. So, in order to avoid the inconvenience and also for the people to stand in a big queue, so what was started? The reservations could be done computerized, that is online. Okay. So it was started first time in Delhi in 1984, and in the same year the metro was started in Kolkata. Yes. Then next, in this way India has been making progress in the fields of science and technology. So we could see that in this way India had made progress in the field of science and technology. New inventions have been made and India is an important 21st century. So new inventions have been made in India. So India is considered to be most as an important in the 21st century, as because a lot of progress was done. So India, a 21st century nation, it was considered, which has always used technology for establishing peace in the world. So, it has always used technology for establishing peace in the world, and India is making all these advancements in order to be the foremost among nations in the 21st century. So, India is considered to be as an important nation in the 21st century, as it has done a technological progress more in the field of science as well. And the most important thing is India has not made use of this technology for any kind of destruction, but on the other hand, it had tried to improve the situations in the country, for the betterment of the country, for the development of the country. And so India has made all this advancement in order to be the foremost among the nations in the 21st century. So in this way, children, in this lesson we have learned from part 1 to part 5 about all kinds of science and technological development that India has taken in the field of space research, in the field of telecommunications, also in the field of transportations, and this way how it proved to be one of the foremost nation in bringing about technological development in the 21st century. So we shall stop here for the day. Thank you, children.